happen. So, if we understand what love is all about, and then we know what the law of love is all about, we will manifest the blessings attached to love by understanding the cost of love. Praise God. Praise God. Please turn in your Bible tonight, Matthew 22. Matthew 22. 35 and 36. The world, the earth in which we live in is called the cosmos system. Am I right, geographers? It is called the cosmos system, C-O-M-O-S, system. And if it is called the cosmos system, and God in his wisdom had created a law in which every system operates or functions, the success of every system or any system is based upon the operation of the law attached to that system. Am I right? Now, if this earth is a cosmos system, it means there are certain laws that God had put in place that make this earth to work. If you look around you today, the earth seems to be failing. In terms of security, it's failing. In terms of life value, it's failing. In terms of moral, it's failing. Where people begin to bind the scripture, Bible, in secular education to make room for other immoral things to be in practice, it shows that the earth is decaying. And one of the reasons why the earth is decaying is because the earth or the leaders of the earth have not been able to bring into operation what the system, what will make the cosmos system to be a success. Praise God. What makes this cost to be a success? Praise God. It is programmed that one of the law of the aqua life is that everything that has to live in the water must obey its location and live there to survive. It's a law. So if you take a fish out of the water, you are breaking the system that is made for the aqua life. And so the system will fail because you remove the fish from its system. God designed the fish and put a principle in it for the fish to survive and become to live or exist by that system, that principle of living in the water. And so when God created the earth, he saw that there is nothing that will make the earth to function the way it should. He began to put laws. He put laws in place that govern the earth. And so, one of the laws that govern the earth is that if you jump from a height, you will go down. And if the height is beyond proportion, you will die. Your understanding of that law will make you not to. Am I here? So, as a believer, as a human being, when you check the Bible from creation up unto the time of Moses, people woke up to do the things that they like. Cain woke up and killed Abel. No police was involved. Because he didn't understand at that time he was killing Abel that there is a principle on earth that when you kill, that blood is answerable. It calls out for you, becomes like a witness against you. And so it was when he had killed that God now came in the picture and said, the blood of thy brother, that was when the awareness came to him. So if I kill, there will be a cry against my life. He never understood the law of life. So he felt taking life was to give himself an advantage. But then he realized that it was not that. That's not how God created. God created every atmosphere, every system, and put a principle that makes that system to work. And so when light continued and it came to the point of Moses, and then God had begun to deal personally with the nation called Israel, God needed them to understand that there is a part of the earth that they need to understand. And that part of the earth, the system, is the laws. So it is not that you are created to live the way you want. You are created to live with the dictate of the principles and the system of the system that will make you to become fruitful or productive in the system. And so God saw the way Israel were living their lives, and God said, if I lead these people, they will make this earth a place of disharmony for themselves, for any neighbor around them. So God called Moses and made that invisible principle that makes the earth to work, he made it visible to Moses. So you don't have to break the system, break the principle for you to see it. So you need to see the principle so you can get a result in the system. He called Moses unto him in the mountain and gave Moses 10 laws. 10 laws. 10 laws. Of that 10 laws, theologically, there are over 600 laws that are attached to that 10 laws. The interpretation of those 10 laws will mean the understanding of over 630 something laws that are set on motion that will make the system of the earth work in the life of an average Israelite. And so this principle, these laws, guided Israel up until the time that Jesus came. And when Jesus came, he himself, to become productive in the system, also followed the law. Am I here? He followed the law. He lived the law. He followed the principle. And so he himself got the understanding and then came to a point where he needed to establish another testament. The people came to him in Matthew 22. I need to explain why I'm reading using Matthew 22. Praise God. Am I here? Verse 35. One of them, a lawyer. Now look at the person that came to ask the question. A lawyer. Because he understood certain things about law and certain things about principles that makes things to work. So he was looking at the life of Jesus. Things are working for him. Everything he says comes to pass. Everything he wants to do, he sees. So they are wondering what are the things. And then they also know that God had given them a law that had been guiding them. But this one seemed to be operating in certain dimension that is beyond their comprehension. And so they came to him, a lawyer. That's why I like lawyers. They are always very curious, always going for knowledge. So one of them came to him. Who was that? A lawyer. Go ahead. He asked Jesus a question to test him. To test who? Him. Go ahead. Teacher. Which is the greatest commandment in the law? In the law that God gave to us that has been making things to work for us as a nation. You are a nation. If things must work for you, there are certain principles and law that worked for Jesus that is working for Israel that will work for you. I don't know if you know that Israel today, they are a small nation, but they have become so powerful. Every time you follow, lay down rules and laws and principles, you become stronger than your enemies. So they came to him to test him. Now they were testing him, but they didn't know that he understood the plan of God better than anyone on earth. Go ahead. Yes. And Jesus 35. Jesus was at 35. 35, okay. 37. Jesus replied him and said, hear this. Which of the laws is the greatest? Look at how Jesus came to answer him. Don't forget that an average Jewish man understands these 10 laws, these 10 commandments, and they also understand these over 600 laws. They understood it. Now, for them to ask, they are testing the knowledge of Jesus if his knowledge is beyond the 10. And so he began answering them with a simple sentence. What does he say? Thou shalt love the Lord your what? Lord. Thy God. You shall love the Lord your God. Love the Lord your God with all. Go ahead. And with all your soul. And with all your might. This is the first and the greatest law. It means that the law of love is one of the greatest law that God had put in place on the earth for harmony. One of the reasons why there seems to be harmony on the earth is because the laws are not being obeyed. Who will kill his brother if he obeys this law? Who will kill his wife if he obeys this law? Who will kill his neighbor if he obeys this law? Praise God. We say the law of love. Say it louder, the law of love. Say it if you mean it, the law of love. Now hear me. Jesus said, you shall love the Lord your God. Nobody can manifest love that has not love, come to love God. Nobody on earth can display the love that God is talking about here that has not come to know God. And if you read on in the passage, it says to us, also you will love your neighbor as thyself. So there are three stages of love that can be manifested for you to experience the blessings of love. Number one, you must love the Lord thy God. Number two, you must love yourself. Number three, you must love your neighbor. You must love God. A man that does not love God will not understand the value of himself to love himself. Your understanding of God concepts opens you up for you concepts. You know you better when you know God. You value you more when you value God. So a man that does not love God can never love himself. Do you know why people commit suicide? They don't love themselves. And it's because they don't love God. When you don't love God, it becomes a hard thing to love yourself. And a man that has not come to love himself can never love any neighbor. So God is so practical when he said, love God, love your neighbor as you love yourself. It means that you must love yourself first, then with the same degree with which you love yourself, love your neighbor. Is this, I should love you before I love me? He says, love God. Then he says, love me. Then I will be able to love you the same degree with which I love myself. And if I love myself, not to be able to come and slap myself, I shouldn't be able to slap you. Am I here? Love yourself enough to protect your own life. In the same way, you will also love your neighbor enough to protect his own life or her own life. The reason God put these things in place and in this sequence is for us to manifest the love of God in our environment, to create harmony in this cosmos system. Praise God. Until you understand this concept, you can never gain from love. You can never gain from love. Love can never bless you. There is so much profit and benefit in loving. Are you with me? When you see a man whose heart is full of love, you will see a man that is living in joy. When you see a man whose heart is full of joy, of love, you will see a man who is always living with joy. When you see people who are always, you know, love is not what you can hide. It's just as you cannot hide God. And because you cannot hide God, you can't hide love. People see love. Love is an invisible experience that has a physical manifestation. When you see a man that is in love, you will see the expression in his face or in her face. Praise God. In Genesis, the Bible told us, and God blessed them and said unto them, be fruitful. God blessed them and said unto them, be fruitful. When you begin to manifest the love of God, you function under the blessings of the Lord. He said to them, when you show forth love, through this love, people will know that indeed you are my what? Disciple. So you are not a disciple because you have a car as a pastor. You are not a disciple because you come to the altar to preach. You are the disciple of Jesus Christ because you carry the t-shirt of TICC. You are a disciple by the manifestation of the love of God in your life. And this manifestation opens the door for blessings. And when you are blessed because of your heart of love, something happens. That's why I went to Genesis. He said, and he blessed them and said unto them, be fruitful. When you are manifesting the love of God and it opens the door of blessing for you, one of the things that shows forth in your life is that you become productive. You become productive. Show me a man who is always angry and bitter. I will show you a failure. Show me a man who is always angry and bitter with life, I will show you a failure. Show me a man who is always joyful and full of love, I will show you a man who will have means. He blessed them. And then he said, be fruitful. That word fruitful means be productive. And to be productive, you cannot be productive until you are a carrier of the blessings of God. And you cannot carry God's blessings until you show forth the love of God. Why? It is the love of God that helps you to manifest kingdom kingdom provisions. Am I still here tonight? Love has a lot of benefit. One, it gives you sound head. Love gives you sound head. Love makes you healthy. It makes you healthy. Have you ever gone to the hospital and then you see a patient who had been abandoned at home, and suddenly he comes to this hospital ward and the nurses are playful, they are caring, they cherish him, they place so much importance and value on him, they talk with him. The same man who has been at home, no one talks to him, the door is locked, they only come to him to give him food, they can't even eat. Now suddenly the man is in the hospital and his people are talking with him, they are touching him, they are asking him questions, how do you feel now, hope you are okay, don't worry, you will be okay. Without Panadol, without Fesic, the healing had begun. Love makes you healthy. That's why one of the things that the devil will do against anyone that he wants to trap, the first thing he does to them is to separate them from the atmosphere of love. Where you start feeling that nobody loves you, nobody cares about you, no one have your time, no one gives you attention, that understanding and that atmosphere alone makes you sick. That is the primary state that puts people into depression. So love of God being expressed in your life or being expressed towards you makes you live a healthy life. So if you want our neighborhood, our environment to be healthy, we should show love towards men. Praise God. Number two, blessings of love. Love creates the atmosphere for a good relationship. Many relationships are failing because love is absent. Many homes are failing because love is absent. Many people who began friendship yesterday are no more friends today because love is absent. The backbone of relationship is love. Praise God. Praise God. Sometimes you wonder, you see two friends of different background, different academic foundation, family background differs, race and color, whatever, they are different, but you just see them harmonizing and relating well. You wonder what is the secret behind, because either of them had felt love for each other. The same way, if you don't love God, you cannot relate with God. If you don't love you, you can't relate with you. The first point of relationship does not begin when you relate with another. It begins when you can relate with yourself. Be your own friend. Be your own friend. When you begin to love God, one thing that God will expose you to as a person, He will expose you to loving you. And when you can love yourself and play with yourself and just be a friend to yourself, it will never be difficult relating with somebody else. So you say, love God with all of your mind, with all of your heart. In other words, love God with everything you've got in your life. If that happens, there's no way you won't love yourself. And if you love yourself, there's no way you won't love your neighbor. Praise God. A crack in these three stages of relationship is why the world is failing. An average man who has not come to know God will not have time loving you. Why? He has not come to love himself. So the only way he thinks he can treat himself and to love himself is to keep money for himself and keep things for himself and acquire things for himself. He's trying to bribe himself to love himself. You don't need money in your account to love yourself. You don't need a husband in your life to love yourself. You don't need a wife in your life to love yourself. Love yourself in the absence of husband. Love yourself in the absence of wife. Love yourself with money or no money. Just love yourself. When there's harmony within you, whatsoever he doeth, he shall what? Prosper. Harmony. People get confused and not be able to make progress because there's no harmony within. There are many inner Boko Haram in our inner system. Inner Boko Haram. War within us. War. Because we have not come, we have not opened up to loving God. So tapping in the blessings of loving becomes a problem. Praise God. Praise God. Love helps you to be patient. It's a blessing. One of the most precious fruits on this earth is the fruit called patience. It's a precious fruit. It is called patience. And it's not found in any in all the gardens. It's only found in the wise man's garden. Patient. It takes loving to be patient. It's a blessing. When you love your children, you'll be patient with them. When you love your friend, you will be patient with him or with her. When you love your husband, you will be patient with him. When you love your wife, you will be patient with her. When you love yourself, you will be patient to achieve your results. Love yourself and be patient to get results. What a blessing to look inward and touch a fruit called love. What a blessing to look inward and see a fruit called patience. What a blessing to look inward and see a fruit called gratitude. In other words, of all the fruits of the Spirit, when you get the fruit of love, the other fruit will produce themselves in your tree. What our world needs is not more money. What Nigeria needs is not more money. What our families, our homes, our children need is not more money. What we need is more love. More love. What you need for that man, that woman who is a neighbor to you, is not how much you can, it's just more love. When you show love to people, one of the blessings is that they will show you their good side. Their good side. I am aware that sometimes when you show love, what you get back is not their good side, it's their evil side. But inside of them, they know that you have showed them love. Inside of them. Just as a serpent could be in danger and you try to help the serpent and it still stings you or beat you. It's his nature to beat, but instead of it, he know that you have helped. In every wicked nature, there is this part in them that tells you, this person have shown me love. When they do, when they have hurt you and walk away, they go home and think, because every human being has a conscience. Love helps people to think inward and bring their good nature. Love. Galatians 5 verse 22. Galatians 5 verse 22. Are you there? Galatians 5:22. Yes. But the fruit of the Spirit is love. Why did it come first? The fruit of the Spirit is what? Love. The reason it came first is because if you have love in your life, it becomes easy to bear the other fruits. It becomes easier to bear the other fruits. But the fruits of the Spirit is love. Love in your life helps you to navigate between the invisible and the visible. It helps you. Love blesses you by protecting you. Love protects. Love protects. Many of us would have died if people around us hate us so much not to protect us. We would have died. We would have died if God didn't love us enough to give us protection. We would have killed our neighbor if we don't love them enough to protect them. Love opened the door for protection. Love is a blessing. To sit down and just begin to imagine that someone somewhere is thinking of how to be a blessing to you without a cause is love. You just sit down somewhere, somebody just think about you and send you some money is love. Love protects. Love does not seek his own. Love rejoices. It is love that makes us to persevere in trying time. Those that cannot persevere in trying time are those that take their life, because there's no love for life, for self. Love is a blessing. If you are alive and you can look within you and see there's a place in you that makes you to love people, it's a great gift from God to you. Some human don't want to see another human. It's not because that's how they are made. It's because that thing called love is not there. That you have it is enough to thank God. Thank God. But these blessings that comes when you love is not easy. It's going to cost you. No genuine love leaves you without a wound. No genuine love. Any genuine lover on the face of the earth is a carrier of wounds. Jesus looked at the disciples and he showed him his palm hands and he said to them, "This I did for you. This I did for you." What made him to bear the pain and took the scar? Love. No genuine love leaves you without a scar. Have you wondered why those you love and sacrifice for the most are the ones that hurt you the most? That's how love is programmed. That's how love is programmed. It's part of the course of love that makes the blessings of love to come alive. If you want to love people and you don't expect to have any scar from them, your love is not genuine. For God so loved the world, and he gave. Nobody will give the only thing that he had without a pain inside. Love will cost you pain. Because of love, God escorted his own son to the cross. And before his very eyes, he opened his eyes and they pierced his own son. And when the son looked at the father could not stand. He said, Father, love will cost you tears. Have you wondered why people that are in love cry a lot? People that are in love, they cry a lot. When you have people around you who tells you, I love you, I love you, I did this, and they have never cried for you, be careful. As mighty as Jesus is, as anointed as Jesus is, as strong and graceful as Jesus is, on the cross, Bible said, he cried. He looked at Lazarus, he cried. Love will cause you tears. Love will make you to shed tears. It's a cost. Oh, you think right now, because he loved me so much. If he loves me, why is he making me to cry? No verse is part of the system. No vessel. Because love itself has a cost. It will cost you something. Love does not mean perfection. So don't think because he loves you, he must be perfect. Are you here with me? Love does not mean perfection. That because he loves you, he must be what? Perfect. No. In fact, the reason you will cry is because you have not come to understand that love itself has a cost. Praise God. Love will cost you your life. For God so loved the world, he gave his only son. The only son so loved the world, he died for the world. So love will cost you your life. Some years ago, a man's wife was sick, very sick, very, very sick. And the man looked at the wife and the pain she was going through. He said, go, this should be me. Give me the pain. Let her live without pain. That is love. Because every genuine love will cost you your life. That is one of the reasons that Christianity in the South is not the same Christianity in the North. They love God so much so to die for God because they appreciate that God died for them. Jesus died for them. So what will stop them from not dying for him? But this part of the earth, they love God when God can produce the figure milk. As long as there's no honey, let us deny God. Love God with all of your heart, with all of your mind, And with the whole of your being simply means surrender your life for the sake of love. If the man doesn't love you enough to die for you, forget it. That is why we have problems in homes. The guy doesn't love you enough to die for you. Because every genuine love will cost you your life. Forget the "I love you" that you hear in the mouth of people. It's not complete. It's not complete. When God tells you "I love you," you will see the manifestation of "I love you." When Jesus said "I love you," you saw it, how his life was laid down for "I love you." I'm not talking about love that ends in feeling. That's not love. I am talking about genuine love that can produce blessing, that you must understand that it has a cost. Praise God. Love will cost you your effort. If a man says "I love you" and there's no effort from him towards you, the guest says "I love you," your wife says "he loves you," husband says, and there's no effort from them towards their relationship, there's no love. Because love will cost you your effort. Love will cost you your attention. He doesn't have time for you, yet he loves you. I doubt that kind of love. Have you ever seen anyone in the Bible that needed the attention of Jesus Christ? I never gave to the person. As far to leper, he gave them attention. To the cripple, he gave them what? Attention. Now look at it. His disciples were professing love also. But when they see the blind man calling on him, "Thou son of David," they told him, "Keep quiet." Love does not ignore. It does not ignore. Love will cost you your attention. Love will cost you your time. "I love you," but "I don't have time. I don't have time. I don't have time." It's a lie. Every faith relationship begins with the sickness that the people involved don't understand the cost of love. Every faith relationship begins with the signs that the people involved don't understand the signs or the cost of love. And the moment they don't understand that love will cost them all of these things, they avoid responsibility. The cost of love, it is the other things you invest in love that makes the blessings of love to come out. So when these things are not invested in it, every relationship, no matter how nice the persons are, will end up in shambles. Why? No input, no output. No input, no output. Don't forget, love will cost you your life. Love will cost you wounds. Love will cost you efforts. Love will cost your time. And love will cost your attention. I'll stop here and take a few questions. A few questions. A few questions. A few questions. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Okay, one of the question here is this. He said, "Is it a must to love someone who you don't like?" and yet you are angry with the person?
Love is a commandment. To like is a choice, but to love is a must. We are commanded by God to love because He knows that through love there will be harmony in the cosmos system, in our families, in our companies, in our offices, in our environment. Love. So we are commanded to love. Anybody who is not obeying the command of love is breaking, is the reason why the earth is failing. Go ahead. Do you hear that? You must love somebody. I am compelled by the scripture to love you, but I am not compelled to like you. Get it straight. I must love you. If I don't love you, I am a sinner. If I don't love you, I am what? A sinner. But I have a choice to like you or not to like you. Go ahead.
Okay, the next question is, it said, how do I love myself and my neighbor?
Praise God. How do I love myself? First of all, when you love God, there will be a relationship between you and God. When you love God, there will be a relationship between you and God. And that relationship will open your understanding to knowing the better you. You will appreciate the better you. You will fall in love with the better you. Have you ever seen before that you hate yourself? Yes, when you do something evil, you hate yourself. At that time, you are not a friend to you. But when you are in love with God, you appreciate who you are now with God. So that opens you up to a better you. When the better you is revealed, you will become your own friend. I don't need my wife to tell me to be talk to me to be happy. Just knowing whom I am in God should make me happy. There are people that are looking for the validation of their partner to be happy. I just came out, I dressed like this, and I came out, and they didn't tell me you are okay. So, no. When you wear something and you feel good inside, you are your own friend. I can love you and make you to wear what you're not happy with. You are following me. I'm happy with you, but you're not happy with yourself. So when you know God, you are free with God, you have a connection between you and God is edified, is activated. The better you will come out, and when you, nobody sees a better man and don't love the man. No, when you see a better man, a good man, you what? The same way, when you see a good you, you will become a friend to you. Now, when you now love you, and you see somebody who is good, now because you have been able to define what good is all about, you will be able to reference good in people. Hallelujah. When you love you, loving me as a pastor will be a problem. Praise God. Yes. Yes. Where my juice now? Oh, give me juice.
Amen. Yeah, it says there's a question here.
Where?
It says,
I go vessel. Ask the question. Amen. When they talk, they go.
It says, after helping someone, he chose not to show gratitude.
And he chose not to show gratitude.
Uh-huh. He said, I swear never to help him again.
Now I swear never to help him again. You have just disqualified yourself from the better you. Because a man that has ingratitude is his problem. It's not your problem. Don't let another man's problem become your problem. you are better and you are a helper. Your helping somebody is not validated by how, no, it's a nature in you to be a helper. That's what makes you better. That somebody else is not better does not mean you won't help. In fact, if the person was good, you would have gone to help. If the person is good, he will be happy what you have. No need to help. Because love makes you productive. Am I still here? Love makes you what? Productive. It makes you productive. You become fruitful. Because you are operating with the love is a nature of God. So when you love, you are operating with the nature of love. And the nature of God will always be what? Productive and fruitful. The orange cannot say, because last year I produced so much orange and everybody had a taste of me. This year, how many times have you gone to tell the orange tree, thank you? Your duty is to bear fruit and give out. Stop looking at those. God bless you. Those who says, you not tell me thank you. And now they flow. And I'll give my wife a mouth, give her. Sip some more. No finish out. Praise God. So don't let someone's bad nature change who you are. I've often told my disciples in this church, I said, some of the things I go through and people do to me is to change me from whom I have decided to be. I have decided to be a good person, to do good. And so people that have helped try to hurt me, but the help is to change me from whom I decided to. I decided to help, so you can't stop me. Don't let someone's ingratitude make you to be ungrateful to the giver, supplier. Go ahead.
This one.
Are you hearing me? Are we? Yes.
Okay, yeah. He says, can love be hidden?
Love cannot be hidden. Nobody can hide love. Love is an invisible feeling that have a very fat physical manifestation. If you look at this hall now, you will tell those who are happy and who are sad. All right. They don't have to say it. Just looking at the facial expression, you can know California smile. And you can know genuine smile. Just looking at the face, you know California smile. This smile, they come from diplomacy. Diplomatic smile, you just know. When you see a man smiling genuinely, you just know. The same way you can't hide love. Praise God. One of the reasons you can't hide love, love will always make you to give. Love guides your decisions and your actions. Love is so powerful that it guides your decision and what? Your actions. So through the decisions a man makes or the action a man takes, you can know if he's loving or he's hating. Praise God. Read more. Are we following these things? You can't hide love. In fact, to hide love is to be sick. Praise God. Read it.
So, is it good to love someone that does not love you, but the boy's mom loves you?
This love I'm talking about is not marriage love. It's genuine love. You don't need him to love you to love him. Just love him.
Amen.
Just love the man. Just love the woman, because they are human beings. When that is established, building a relationship becomes secondary. If you, the reason you will love because you want to marry the person there, you don't love. There's no love. Your love is blank. Your love is based on is what you call philia. Emotion. Because the day that emotion die, even if you got married 20 years later, you will separate the marriage. Praise God. So it's not about the boy love me, but no. We are commanded to love. No condition. You don't need any condition to be good. Am I right? You don't need any condition to be good. God is love. And if you are carrying God, you should be what? You should love. No condition. No condition. The camp president was killed. If you go to heaven and you see him now, what he will be telling you, Father, forgive those that killed me. Because in the realm of the spirit, we don't die, we multiply. No believer dies. We multiply. Yes. So this love is not about boyfriend loving me. No. It's about you loving the person and then making the person to understand what God's love is all about. He loves you back. Then if you decide to build marriage on that, it will grow more. But first of all, what? Love. Praise God. Yes.
This one goes like this. Said, how would one know if he or she feel love?
How do you know if you feel love? How do you treat yourself? How do you treat yourself? How you treat yourself tells you if you love you. If you treat yourself nicely, it tells you you love you. I went somewhere one day and it was raining and the area got flooded. So when we're coming back, I got to the place, a lot of people were pulling their shoe. They pulled their shoe and carried the shoe and used their barefoot to walk the dirty water. So I was coming, I didn't see any need for me to pull my shoe and put my bare leg on the water. So I was walking in the water with my shoe. And the woman said, you don't like your shoe. I said, madam, I like myself past my shoe. How do you treat you? Do you get this? How do you treat you? I had told the story of how a young girl fainted. Whether she died, whether she fainted. I don't know what I would call that one because they rushed her in to the church I was before, dead, no life. So I asked the mother, what happened? Pastor, I don't know. I don't know. She was answering a call. And then suddenly she just fell. And all her body was wet with anointing oil, all kind of oil. They soaked her on oil. And they brought her to church. So I said, bring her down. Put her down. So I said, give me the phone. Which phone was she asking for? Give me the phone. So when they gave me the phone, I thought the last die name popped up and said, mine. So I knew whatever they were talking about was a heartbreak. So, deliverance have different kind of deliverance. So I told the mother, give me some time. I want to pray for her. And then I bend her face very well. It is a deliverance. When I slapped her, she jacked back and said, where are they? You died before. Rubbish. That sister doesn't love herself. Am I still here? She doesn't love herself. You need to love yourself first. Your loving yourself will help you to make decisions that make your life better. God did not give vision to you because you are going to marry James. He gave you vision because of you. And vision is stronger than marriage. So anybody who wants to die because there's no husband, there's no wife, he does not love himself. Love yourself and love all that God gave to you and be a success, their husband will come, your wife will come. When I slapped the girl, I slapped away foolishness and sense came in. And when she woke up, she was trying to, where's my phone? Keep quiet. I gave her again. Twa! You are in church. There are some deliverers we need in church to make some head correct. Because sometimes people just devalue themselves and validate their existence by another person's approval. Anyway, I see copper. See, my boyfriend didn't say, see, he didn't say, we're not married, therefore I would die. He took sniper, and in fact, I should go and give him more sniper in here. How do you treat yourself? If your value of you is based upon what I tell you that you are, you don't love you. If your value of who you are is based upon what I tell you that you are, then you don't love you. Your value of you should be how you have rated yourself, then by why you have rated yourself, that should transcend to me to value you more. You don't need me to give you credibility to become a better you. You need to relate with God and let God reveal you to you. Then you fall in love with you. It doesn't matter what happened outside of you. It does not devalue you. Am I still here? Yes. Time is going to serve. We must live here. Am I right?
This goes like, he said, can only one person be in love?
Can one person be in love? Yes, sir. You can be in love. Don't know. Yes. When you are doing things that makes God happy, that makes you happy, do you need me? You took your, you went to work, took your own money, went to a tailor, social for yourself, bought it for yourself. You took yourself out to Kada Plaza. What do you call love? Give yourself a treat. You can love you. You can love you. What did I say? You can love you. You can love you. You can love you. That is the beginning of harmony. If you are close to anybody that cannot love himself, you are in danger. No matter what you do around them, it can never be appreciated. Read on. We are closing.
Okay, this goes like you said. Please, in terms of effort, it says, it says, please, in terms of effort as regarded love, which one must I put to prove that I really care?
To prove that you really love, you will make effort to show to the person that you love. Love will make you do things that shows love. That's effort. Love will make you do things that shows love. That's effort. It will make you do things that shows love. For example, I love Sister Blessing. I want to give her 10 naira for she's there. Ah, I love her. I love her blessing. But to live here, to give it to her, I don't want to make any effort. But I love her. But to stand up now is a problem. If I want to show that I love her, my only effort is to give it to her. Make effort. Upon these questions, stand on your feet. Stand on your feet.